Yo, D-Smoke. Man, won't you represent the wood one time? Could you please?
Super good, Smitto. D-S-M-O-K-E. Bitch, it's official. I got these other niggas in quite a deal of a pickup. Cause they bitch want me to pour champagne drip off the nipples.
Care.
Yo.
What's up, my G?
There he is.
Good to see
you. Good to see you too, man. So where we at? Where we at?
Oh, man, we at Broadway Boxing Gym, man. Here on Broadway and 108th. The gym I grew up in.
All right, well, let's go inside, man.
All right, for sure. Let's do it. Welcome to Broadway.
Get some cardio in before you even walk
before
in.
Before you even walk up. You know what I'm saying?
This is Broadway Gym, huh?
Yes, sir.
You know how long this place has been here?
Man, it's been here at least since the early 70s, maybe even the late 60s.
Wow.
My uncle was here. He was here when Sugar Ray Leonard was training in here one time. You got some pictures on the wall. I'm gonna find one of them pics. Yeah, it's a lot of history here.
So these are all people who have either came through or?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
See Don King.
Yep.
Young Don King.
Mike Tyson was gonna train here for the Roy Jones fight, the comeback joint. It didn't end up happening.
Oh, here goes Sugar Ray right here.
Oh, wow.
So that was with the previous owner and stuff. Oh, yeah, that's Denzel right here. So.
Denzel.
Yeah.
Yeah, this feels like one of those boxing offices you see in, like...
In a movie, bro.
In a movie, yeah.
This is authentic. It don't get no realer than this.
So, like, what made you kind of want to get into boxing?
I was raised in some boxing gloves, to keep it 100. Like, it wasn't until I got in the gym that I really started... like learning the craft, but I've been fighting since I was 6 years old, 5 years old. You know, Pops was in jail, and my uncle was like, you know, y'all gonna be tough. Like, it's not a choice. So that's how it started. It got serious when I was in a rap duo with my homie Chiz, and he passed. And so what I was doing for sport kind of became like lifestyle, like, all right, you know, this is something that helps keep me in the right mindset. And after I turned 26, I fought 3 times in a 6-month period. And that's when coaches started looking at me like, you might want to go pro, you know, because I won. Nobody wins all 3 of their first fights.
You think you kind of use boxing like kind of like as like a way to deal with like him passing?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Boxing is one of those places or activities where you can clear your mind, bro. You believe it all in the gym, you know, and I needed that at the time. Like I was like, all right. Because it shook us up, like, you know.
I was saying, you feel like you already got your life figured out. Like, yo, this is what we're going to be doing for the next 10 years. We're going to make it. We're going to get signed.
Period.
And yeah, and someone passes. It's like, now what?
Now I had to go. This is the drawing board. Back to the drawing board, you feel me? So I'm going to go ahead and wrap my hands, too.
Oh, yeah, let's do that. Summer in the wintertime. Smoke back on this beat, act like it's dinner time. 4 packs, no receipt, no low jack, hold my heat in case I have to throw that in the river after center time.
Set the clock. When that bell go off, we got 3 minutes of jump rope. You might want to back up. That's the first thing you feel like you got to learn how to do well. When you see the other people do it.
Yeah.
You get in here and you be like, oh, dang, I don't have them skills.
I don't jump rope like that.
Ah, trying to make it to the last clip. Bing, bing.
I think I've done more cardio watching you do that than I've done I'm out of breath watching that.
So typically we do 3 rounds of that and 3 rounds of shadow boxing. We're gonna do 1 round of each because I'm not in boxing shape and for the demonstration. My coach used to have me shadow box for so many rounds, no less than 6.
What led to the idea of you purchasing the building?
That was us purchasing the building. It came as the end result of a series of unfortunate events. The owner passed, and then her son tragically passed. And everybody who trained here was like, what's about to happen, you know?
Right.
Because I imagine it's a huge property, you know? They might just sell it. Whoever inherits it, it's like they don't have the same loyalty to the space and to what it served.
Yeah.
So we're like, nah, it's a community that's, you know, built here. Miss Larkins loved Miss Art Larkins. She was like a mom to everybody that came through here, you know. She loved me, you know. She believed in me as fighter, musician, all of that.
So can I ask you a question?
Yes, sir.
So who run the gym, you?
Huh?
It's yours?
It's mine, yes.
Talk.
How you doing? Good to see you around here.
Yeah.
did you? Yes, sir.
This is our monument. This is very important, and I'm glad, man. I'm proud. I'm thankful for that. Because this is something that we didn't want to lose. This is the ground. This is Broadway. It never be another one of these.
Period.
Gangbangers, they wouldn't come in here and start no trouble or nothing. They'll come in, watch sport and all that. Won't be none of that riffraff in here. Because that's what it was. It was about respect, you know.
You trying to spar? What's up, man? You want to get some rounds in? I'm just fucking with you.
Man, I might look young, man. You know, but I'm kind of old.
Hey, man. So, much love.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Y'all take it easy.
Yes, sir.
I was off for a second, now I'm back.
How you feeling? Happy New Year, dog.
Happy New Year, bro.
It's a new year.
You know I got some Don King. I'm going to find you a squabble.
Man, find me one.
I ain't going back and forth. I hope they free the homie when he go back to court. I be thinking about Nip. Like, I got to keep this shit going strong for the Crips.
How did you guys connect? Because obviously, while you're training and he's rapping downstairs, you guys didn't have a relationship, so.
Man, the first time I met G.Perico, it was the day I fought here. And it'd be a line around the block of people and their families coming. They open up downstairs to serve breakfast to the fighters on one side. On the other side, they got the store active. So I actually walk up on him like, hey, you know, I'm about to fight today, but, you know, my name's Smoke. I rap. I'm from Inglewood, you know. And then he down there with his homies. He didn't skip no beat. His homie next to me was like, Inglewood. He said, like, you just gonna tell niggas that? Like, you just gonna announce that? Like, that was our first interaction. And then, just over the years, niggas just stayed in contact.
Yeah, I didn't even know this nigga had, I just know he had the squabble.
Yeah, You didn't know he was nice.
Did all that shit, nah.
Did you guys ever have any sort of, like, inclination that you ever might even, you know, have a chance to own a place like this, this place specifically?
It always been in my mind. Like, always. Always sitting down there, like, cause that's just how I think. Like, I changed my life right here, though. You know what I mean? Mm. When I got out, like, I was still straddling the fence, and then I locked in downstairs. Bro, I was the person that took advantage of the space, like you said. That space saved me. I sat up in here, I saw the future. We talking almost 10 years ago now.
What about you, Smoke?
First time I thought of, like, owning Broadway, I think it was when I started to notice that Miss Larkins wasn't doing so well. Because, you know, spaces change drastically when you got the rollover of personnel. If you one of those people that's valuable to a space, you know, like, hey, man, if I leave, this is different. Miss Larkins, with her leaving, you know, we knew who Roth was. We loved Roth. That was our dude. But in a lot of ways, he was his own. He was his own monster.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And he wasn't, for sure wasn't his mom. You know, so I had already had concerns, but I would never disrespect the family by overstepping him and being like, Miss Larkins, let's have a real conversation about what the vision, the long-term vision is for this place. So how do you have that conversation? But those were thoughts I was really having because I was like, I'm winning. You know, she was still here, like, after Rhythm and
she
Flow.
She got to see.
I had 300 people in here, you know what I'm saying? Sure enough, when that time limit came for everybody to get the fuck out, she was like,
she don't
I need y'all
no
to get
game.
The fuck out. Then finally when they leave, she's like, okay, love you, great job. You know what I'm saying? Like,
for real.
Like, and so she got a chance to see all that. She knew I was capable. I knew I was capable, but, you know, when she started to decline, I'm like, this space is special. What's gonna happen? Man, there's so many handwritten signs, bro. Her handwriting is still on the walls. You move machines, you move them back. Clean up after yourself. Yeah. It's no kicking the bags over there. That's her handwriting. You know what I'm saying? So it's not just mean without a whole vision for how they're supposed to operate. She was about it. Ran it from front to the back. There's no currency that can measure the value you knew it possessed to her. She was one of those that where if the gym was struggling, we didn't know.
So the goal is to keep this place open with the spirit that she carried. Yeah,
absolutely.
The story of the Broadway gym continues.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
Say go, buy back the block where the leg goes. If a nigga hate, then it's case closed. You looking at the grave with the say so. I'm ready. Say go, generating guac in the pesos.
We already got what we pray for. Looking at your watch, what you wait for? Yes. There you go. You're guaranteed to fail if you aim low. And even after hell, get a rainbow. They couldn't chip my nail with a chainsaw. I'm ready. Halos. I lost a couple G's now.